Hey guys, it's Bren. I'm here with a small haul, which I'll show you at the end of the video, as well as a review for Blackberry Tea Leaf. This is a new candle that just came out. Well, actually, it's officially coming out on the floor at stores nationwide tomorrow, Monday the 27th, but a lot of stores had it over this past weekend. It was online over this past weekend. I was able to score one. So a little history lesson is needed before we get into this. This candle, this year, it did appear in some test stores, but it was a very, very scarce. It was only in a couple. It was not in the test store that I went to, so I didn't get to smell it until now. But it was on Instagram a couple of months ago. No one knew if it was really going to officially come out nationwide until it popped up online a couple days ago. But here it is now. There has been a lot of talk this season about the old Bath & Body Works candle, Blueberry Pumpkin Patch, because they came out this year again with another blueberry candle, Blueberry Maple Pancakes. But Blueberry Pumpkin Patch was also repackaged in 2013, I think, as Blackberry Bramble Tea. And everyone agreed those two were the same. Blueberry Pumpkin Patch and Blackberry Bramble Tea were the same candle. They were the same scent. I smelled them side by side. I remember knowing that they were the same. And then when Blueberry Maple Pancakes came out this year, some people were comparing it to Blueberry Pumpkin Patch because Bath & Body Works doesn't do blueberry a lot. I didn't believe that they smelled the same at all to me. Honestly, Blueberry Maple Pancakes smelled like maple syrup, sweet blueberry, like blueberry syrup that you would put on pancakes. And I didn't have a Blueberry Pumpkin Patch or Blackberry Bramble Tea to compare it to, but I remembered that scent and I just was like, just doesn't smell like what I remember that smelling like, but I didn't have them in person, so I couldn't say for sure. However, there were some people reporting that this Blackberry Tea Leaf candle was a repackage of Blueberry Pumpkin Patch / Blackberry Bramble Tea, and so it was like, well, if that's true, when this comes out, we'll be able to do a side-by-side. So, it would make sense, it would make perfect sense that a candle called Blackberry Tea Leaf with the notes, wild blackberry, Bramble Tea Leaves and hint of sweet orange would be a repackage of Blackberry Bramble Tea. It doesn't make sense why that was a repackage of Blueberry Pumpkin Patch based on the names, but here's the thing. When I smelled this, I picked it up, I opened it up, it hit me. That memory came forth from Blueberry Pumpkin Patch / Blackberry Bramble Tea. I was like, yes. This is what Blackberry Bramble Tea / Blueberry Pumpkin Patch smelled like, but I'm not sure it's an exact repackage, but it's got that same berry note, which to me, I can confirm now with absolute certainty, is very different from what we're getting in Blueberry Maple Pancakes. That's just, it's a totally different candle. Just don't even think about that one anymore. This candle, it's almost worth like buying an old Blueberry Pumpkin Patch on Mercari or something just so I can side by side it with this, because in my memory, there's just this huge similarity, but I can't say for certain if this is slightly different or not. People are saying that they think it's slightly different. However, a lot of people, when Blueberry Pumpkin Patch and Blackberry Bramble Tea came out, didn't put that together. I didn't until someone else brought it up, because those are just completely different names, completely different notes. But Bath & Body Works has done that before, repackaged a candle under a totally different name with totally different notes, but it's the same scent. And so it's like, I don't know. I know, what I do know is Blueberry Pumpkin Patch was a little weird. It was a little just off, I don't know. It had a blueberry scent, but it wasn't that sweet. And it had this mix of what at the time I remember calling like a pumpkin spice, because there was something with the blueberry that just made it kind of weird. However, in this candle, people are getting like a berry scent with tea and saying it's tea, but I'm not so sure that the pumpkin spice that I remember smelling before and the tea note that you get in this candle are different things, or if it's just the name suggests something and your brain thinks that's what it is then. Because honestly, this candle smells a heck of a lot like I remember Blueberry Pumpkin Patch / Blackberry Bramble Tea smelling. I just really wish I could do a side-by-side, but I can't. What I can tell you is that this is very similar to the old Blackberry Bramble Tea Blueberry Pumpkin Patch. If not exactly the same, it might be exactly the same. That all being said, end of history lesson. Let's just talk about this candle because a lot of you probably haven't smelled Blueberry Pumpkin Patch or Blackberry Bramble Tea. So let's just talk about it. So I already listed the notes for you. It's basically blackberry tea, and they say hint of orange, which I don't know. I don't really get that. As far as the berry scent, it could be blackberry, it could be blueberry. Like a lot of Bath & Body Works candles, the berry scents are sort of interchangeable to them. Honestly, it's not sour enough for me to want to say it's blackberry. It's different than the blackberry in like the old blackberry spice candle. Interestingly enough, the blackberry spice candle was repackaged as blueberry pumpkin strudel in later years. So their blackberry and their blueberry, they like to just switch those two around interchangeably. They also will switch around blueberry and raspberry sometimes, raspberry and strawberry. Berry is berry to Bath & Body Works, pretty much. But it does have a kind of sweet berry scent. But then it's just, there's something else. But it doesn't scream tea to me. Maybe it's tea. But I would believe that it's kind of like an herbal tea, like a floral tea. I don't like floral teas that much. But it's got a softness to it that's almost as if like it was like blackberry or blueberry with like a jasmine tea or something. And it's just got a little bit of earthiness that I guess you could call the tea, but see, that earthiness to me, that tea, whatever is supposed to be a tea note in here, if you called it on the packaging like spice or like cardamom or cinnamon or any kind of like pumpkin spice, like I would believe that too. Power of suggestion. It's berry with something else. And I think people are going to disagree with me on this. Even my mom, to her, it smells like tea. Flat out. She's like, it's a really strong tea scent. People have been saying on Instagram, it's a really strong tea scent. But I don't know. I'm not a tea expert, so maybe I just can't put my finger on this type of tea. But all I know is it's a complex, fall-inized. Is that a word? I'm making it up. They've fallenized, autumnized. I don't know. Added some fall scent to a berry scent with this candle. But it still has a little bit of like, it just comes off as a bit odd to me in the same way that Blueberry Pumpkin Patch and Blackberry Bramble Tea did. So if I had to put my money on it, if I had to bet $20, I would bet it's the same exact candle. But I don't know. I don't know. Just that bet is, I'm not basing that on scent memory so much as just knowing Bath & Body Works and having done this before. So many times they've put out a scent and people swear it's different than something else, but like it's not. Then when you actually get both side by side, you're like, wow. So anyway, yeah, that's my thought on the scent. So it's pretty strong too. I feel like this review has kind of like already gone on too long and I'm just repeating myself. Let's get down to strength and throw. Strength and throw has been pretty darn strong, like an 8. My mom said the same thing. Very strong throwing candle. Performance-wise, it's been fine too. Because she brought it out of the back room for me, I didn't want to be picky and be like, I don't want that one. It has off-center wicks. They're getting better. They were like super off-center, like all within one half of the candle before I burned it. But it has been burning just fine anyway. And this packaging is, it's okay to me. Like it's the only one I have in this collection, so it doesn't match anything else that I have. I like frosted glass, but anyway, it's fine. The lids are pretty cute, actually. They have like little leaves and an acorn. Or no, I guess it's just leaves. This one looked kind of like an acorn, but you know, you got a leaf pattern on them. And so that's about it. But yeah, this collection just will drop tomorrow in stores. And that's all I'll say about that. Those are my thoughts. Feel free to disagree. I'm not adamant about this. Like I am sometimes very adamant, like about certain things, you know, lime granita margarita is not island margarita, you know, certain things where I know this is a repackage no matter what you say, that kind of thing. I'm not like that with this candle. I fully admit like they could be wrong, but like that's what I'm getting and that's what I think and what my memory is believing about this candle. I also picked up a couple other things when I was at the store. I picked up a Halloween soap. I went in there to smell all the Halloween soaps. I was particularly interested in Witch Please because it said it was a caramel apple type scent. And if that had smelled like the caramel apple candle, I would have been really excited. But it didn't. It was just really, it has butterscotch in it too. It just smelled like straight butterscotch, way too sweet. But I did pick up the candy corn, which is supposed to be raspberry, citrus, and nectarine. It smells really good to me. It almost has like a grape popsicle thing going on, but like it's not just grape. It's very much like raspberry. It reminds me of like a raspberry candy. Like I feel like maybe not in the regular pack, but like in the variety, like a tropical fruit pack, like Gummy Savers, there's a raspberry one. Or like there are these little candies called Sunkissed Fruit Gems, and my mom sometimes puts them in like my stocking. I think they're vegan. That's what she did this past year for me. But they have like a raspberry one, and that's what this smells like. Kind of a raspberry Jolly Rancher even. Like it's got a raspberry candy vibe going on. I don't know that I'm even that into the packaging, and it doesn't smell like a fall scent, but I might use this soap in like my marble soap holder or something. I really like the scent. I might actually get more. It's good. It's a good one. And then I also had a couple of little like free body care item up to $5.50 coupons. So it's funny, they had stopped sending me the mailer coupons, but I have the Bath & Body Works app, which I still think is maybe only available in the Chicago and like LA areas. It's been like that for a while, so you'd think they would make a decision about whether or not they're going to put it nationwide or not. Maybe they're not, but they're going to keep it going here. I don't know. But in the app, you get your coupons in the app, so they stopped sending them to me in the mail. Now they've started sending them to me in the mail again the past couple of times, but if I use the mail coupons, they disappear out of my app, so they are connected. But anyway, I had like free body care item up to $5.50, and those are just, when you're going for like signature collection, it's just worthless because all the new seasonal scents only come out in like the $6 body creams or something, And I don't want any of the standard signature scents that they have all year round. I don't like any of them, and I don't need any of them. But my store lets you use those coupons on these. And I don't know if they're supposed to or not, but they do. And then I also had a birthday reward in the app. The birthday reward was a free body care item up to $6 with purchase. And I was like, that's all I get for my birthday? Like, I was expecting like maybe free full-size body care item with a purchase or something, but like to send for your birthday pretty much the same coupon that everybody gets every month, that was kind of lame. But anyway, that's how I got two of these. So I got sweet cinnamon pumpkin and a marshmallow pumpkin latte. And this one does not smell like the body care. The little cream doesn't smell like the body care. The little cream smells more just like marshmallow and vanilla, but it doesn't have that spiciness to it at all. I actually kind of like it better. But it smells more like Beach Night Summer Marshmallow or something than it does the actual Marshmallow Pumpkin Latte Body Care. Sweet Cinnamon Pumpkin smells just like the body care, but like the body care smells nothing like the home fragrance. I don't like the candle at all. I like the body care. But then what I actually wanted to talk about was that I saw in this form, Sweater Weather had come out in the tiny hand cream, and this is going to be launching in a full line of body care. Unfortunately, I was really disappointed with the little hand cream. I'm hoping that the body care smells different than the little hand cream, but I wouldn't count on it. It's probably going to be the same. And the thing was, Sweater Weather, the candle is just, it's eucalyptus, it's cool, it's refreshing, and then it's got pine, and the pine really gives it some bite and some sharpness. And this body, or this little cream, I put it all over my arm and I was smelling it all night. It didn't smell like pine. It didn't smell like eucalyptus. It just smelled like a perfume scent, like a little bit floral, just kind of like a young girl's perfume, like really soft, light, perfumey scent. And it was just really vague and it didn't stand out to me as anything special. So I was really disappointed. And it kind of makes me feel like they're just calling it Sweater Weather as like a gimmick so people get excited about it. They take a beloved candle like Sweater Weather. Oh, we're turning it into a body care, but then the body care is nothing like the candle, and it's just all hype. I don't know. Hot Cocoa and Cream is supposed to be coming out in a body care too, and I hope they don't mess that one up. But anyway, last thing I grabbed, and this was with the rewards from the app. You spend so much, you get a reward. I did grab a full-size sweet cinnamon pumpkin lotion because, like I said, I like the body care in this scent, even though I hate the home fragrance. I don't know. Go figure. Usually, I try to hold off for the Halloween packaging because this scent usually comes out in Halloween packaging with black cats on it. I have a cream from last year with the black cat on it, but I was out of the lotion, so I grabbed one of those. So anyway, that was a really small haul and just grabbing this candle. This might be my last fall candle review. This might be my last fall haul, too, because, as you guys probably already know, winter test candles are coming out tomorrow. Holiday already. I made a joke a couple weeks back that by time Sweet Cinnamon Pumpkin Body Care comes out, I'm going to be ready for Vanilla Bean Noel. And now here it is, holiday test candles. So I'm going to try to get a hold of them. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it. That is still to be determined, but we'll have holiday things to talk about soon. So stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching. As always, you can follow me on Instagram @candlesandmusic. I'll see you guys later. Bye.